गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्लाइकोसाइड्स। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द एल्केलॉइड्स, द फिनोमेना ऑफ एल्केलॉइड्स, व्हाट आर द एल्केलॉइड्स, एंड नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्लाइकोसाइड्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। ग्लाइकोसाइड्स मे बी डिफाइंड एज द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स ऑफ प्लांट और एनिमल ऑरिजिन व्हिच आर एंजाइमेटिक और एसिड हाइड्रोलिसिस गिव वन और मोर शुगर मॉइटीज अलोंग विद नॉन शुगर मॉइटी। The sugar moiety is known as the glycon part and the non-sugar moiety is called as aglycon or genin part. The linkage between aglycon and glycon is called glycosidic linkage. A glycosidic bond is a covalent bond that binds the sugar molecule to another molecule that may or may not be sugar molecule. Chemically, they are sugar ethers formed by interaction of hydroxyl group, each of non-sugar and sugar moieties, with a loss of water molecule. The sugars involved in glycosides are of different types, but most commonly it is beta-D-glucose. The other sugars found are galactose, mannose, rhamnose, saccharose, etc. According to chemical nature of aglycon moieties, glycosides are grouped into or classified as: number one is anthraquinone or anthracene glycosides, cardiac glycosides, saponin glycosides, cyanogenetic or cyanophoric glycosides, isothiocyanate glycosides, flavonoids, coumarin, aldehyde, phenol, steroidal, and miscellaneous glycosides. But according to the linkage across aglycon and glycon part, they are classified as C glycosides, O glycosides, S glycosides and N glycosides. Glycosides are crystalline or amorphous substances which are soluble in water and dilute alcohol but are insoluble in organic solvent like chloroform or ether. Now let's discuss its isolation, that how we can isolate the glycosides from any drug. Glycoside containing drug is finely powdered, then it is extracted with the method of hot percolation using alcohol as a solvent. Then also extraction should be carried out below 45 degrees Celsius as the high temperature may cause a degradation of the drug. Then extract is treated with the lead acetate. Tannins precipitate out, indicating that the impurities are removed. And then hydrogen sulfide gas, H2S gas, is passed through the solution to precipitate excess of the lead acetate as a lead sulfide. Extract is filtered and concentrated to obtain crude glycosides. Extract can be purified by fraction crystallization and chromatographic techniques like PLC, HPLC, GC, etc. And it finally, drug can be characterized or identified by IR, UV, and NMR as well. Now, let us discuss the identification test for glycosides. There are basically two types of tests: Bontrager test and modified Bontrager's test. Bontrager test, the procedure is we have to take the 1 gram of the drug, which is boiled in 5 to 10 ml of dilute HCl for the 10 minutes, and then filter that solution, and in the filtrate filtrate is treated with chloroform or benzene. Then that filtrate, again we have to filter that solution, and then the filtrate is treated with ammonia solution. If the solution gives pink or red color, then the test is passes, or that there will be a positive test which represent the presence of the glycosides in the drug. And in the modified Bontrager test, we can take the 5 ml of dilute HCl and FeCl3, means each we have to take dilute HCl and FeCl3, and then in this solution we can add, or we have to add 1 gram of the drug and mix it well. After mixing, we can boil this solution for 10 minutes, cool, and filter. The filtrate is extracted with chloroform or benzene, treated with ammonia solution, and as a result, if the solution turns pink or red in color, then there will be positive result, means the test passes and the drug contains the glycoside. If there is no color or change in color, then there will be negative results. Now, what are the therapeutic effects? Basically glycosides used to treat edema caused by weakened heart, and pharmaceutical applications. Glycosides can have various uses because glycosides have very important activity, like they are used as cardiotonic, antiseptic, anti-inflammatory, anti-rheumatic, laxative, and purgatives. They are also used as diuretic and analgesic, as an antibiotic, antispasmodic. They are also used in cosmetic and perfumeries and inks. And at last, there is a occurrence and distribution that where we can find the glycosides. So glycosides are commonly or widely distributed in roots, barks, fruits, and to a small extent in the leaves. And the example of the digitalis, the drugs containing glycosides are aloes, senna, digitalis, brahmi, and gokhuru. I hope the concept of the glycosides is very much clear. Thank you so much.